Hi students, so we were studying about animal tissues and last class we have studied about epithelial tissue and which are the different types of epithelial tissues, squamous epithelium, stratified squamous epithelium and columnar epithelium, ciliated columnar epithelium, cuboidal epithelium, all these we have studied. So today we can study about another type of tissue called connective tissue. So today we can study about connective tissue. So from that name itself, we know this is the tissue that connects different parts of the body. So it connects bone to bone, or a bone to muscle, or it can also give support to various parts of body. And the cells of this connective tissue are living cells. Okay, and the cells in this connective tissue, they are loosely packed, or in some they are tightly packed also. And they the cells are, or the space in between these cells are filled with a non-living substance called matrix. So the space between the cells are filled with a non-living substance. So if these are the cells, the space between these cells, the space between these cells are filled with a non-living substance called matrix. Okay, and this or the cells are embedded in a substance called matrix. So the cells are embedded in a substance called matrix. So these are the cells, and the cells are embedded in a substance called matrix. And this matrix, it may be solid. In some connective tissue, it is liquid. In some, it is jelly-like. So the nature of the matrix is different in different connective tissue. In some bone, we can see matrix is solid. In blood, we can see matrix is fluid. So it is different. So the nature of the matrix is different in different connective tissue. So based on the function of the connective tissue, the nature of the matrix is different. Okay. And this is intercellular matrix. Intercellular matrix means what? Matrix that is present in between the cells. Inter means between. So intercellular means between the cells. Okay. And then you know, blood is one connective tissue. So first we can study about blood. So blood is a connective tissue. And it links different parts of the body and maintains a continuity in the body. And it includes blood and lymph. Lymph is also a connective tissue. And what about the matrix of blood? We have studied. Matrix of blood is liquid. And this liquid part of blood is called plasma. So what is the name of the matrix of blood? Matrix of blood is called plasma, or the liquid part of blood is called plasma. And we have studied the cells are embedded in the matrix. So the various cells in the blood, or the blood cells, are embedded in this plasma. And which are the blood cells? Red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets. So RBC, that is red blood cell or red blood corpuscle, WBC, white blood cells or white blood corpuscles, and platelets. So blood have a liquid plasma, and that is the matrix of blood, and it is composed of RBC, WBC and platelets. So these three cells are embedded in this liquid matrix called plasma. And what is the function of RBC? RBC, it have a red pigment called hemoglobin, and this hemoglobin has a great affinity for oxygen, so it will bind with oxygen and carries oxygen. So function of red blood cell is that it carries oxygen. Then what about white blood cells? They give immunity to our body. They will protect our body from diseases, or they will fight against germs. And platelets, they help in the clotting of our blood. So if there is any wound in our body, bleeding continues, if it won't clot, what happens? We will die. But after a few minutes, we can see the blood will clot. It is due to the action of platelets. So platelets will help in the clotting of our blood also. Okay. Then what about the matrix? Matrix is a liquid matrix, and it is rich in some hormones, proteins, and salts. So the matrix of blood is rich in hormones, proteins, and salts. Then what about the function of blood? We know when we breathe, oxygen reaches our lungs. From lungs, oxygen is carried to all the cells in our body by our blood. And when oxygen reaches there, respiration takes place in our cells and carbon dioxide is produced. And this carbon dioxide is carried back to our lungs by our blood. Then digestion is completed in our small intestine. From small intestine, this digested food is carried to all the cells in our body by our blood. Then what are the other functions? Waste materials will be formed in the cells. And all these waste materials are carried by blood to our kidney, and it is, wastes are filtered by our kidney, and it is removed in the form of urine from our body. Then our endocrine gland secretes some hormones, and these hormones are carried by our blood to the target sites and all. So blood carries respiratory gases like oxygen and carbon dioxide. Blood carries food, hormone, waste material, etc. to different parts of our body. Next connective tissue is bone. We know bones give support to our body, bones give shape to our body, it forms the framework of our body. Okay, so what about the matrix? Will it be solid or liquid? Surely it is solid matrix, because it is giving strength and support to our body. So the matrix is solid. So it have a solid matrix, and this matrix is filled with phosphorus and calcium. So matrix is rich in calcium and phosphorus. Solid matrix is rich in calcium and phosphorus, and it is very strong, and it is a non-flexible tissue. What about the tissue? Tissue is non-flexible. We know bones are non-flexible. Okay, so bone is a connective tissue, and matrix is solid, and it is rich in calcium and phosphorus, and it gives strength and support and shape to our body. It forms the framework of our body, and it is non-flexible tissue. Then we know bones are so there are 206 bones in our body, and each bone is joined to other bones, and that part is called joints. So here we can see one joint is there. There is one bone here, and it is joined to two bones in our forearm also, and this is our joint. So one bone is joined to another bone, and that part is called joint. Okay, joints. So here one bone is connected to or joined to another bone by another kind of connective tissue. And the connective tissue that connects one bone to another bone, that connective tissue is called ligament. So what is the name of the connective tissue? That is called ligament. So ligament is a connective tissue that connects one bone to another bone. And when we look at the matrix, it have very little matrix. Very little matrix and this is elastic. Ligament is elastic in nature and it give considerable strength also to this part. Okay, so bone is connected to another bone by connective tissue called ligament with very little matrix and which is elastic. Okay, then we know bones are connected to muscles also. Bones and muscles together make movement in our body. So bones are connected to the muscles also. So there is another connective tissue that connect bone with muscle, and that connective tissue is called tendons. So tendons connect bones to muscles. So bones are attached to muscles by tendons, and this is a fibrous tissue. So what about tendons? They are fibrous. They are fibrous tissue, and they give great strength to that part, and they have limited flexibility. What about ligament? Ligament is elastic, but here tendons have limited flexibility, and they will give great strength also. Okay, then we know in addition to bones, there are some cartilages also in our body. Then cartilages means what? They are soft bones. So when we look at the tip of our nose, we know it is flexible. Or when we look at the ear, you can fold the ear, it is also flexible. So this is not made of bone. Here we can see it is made of cartilage. So cartilage means soft bone. And in cartilage, the cells are widely spaced. So there is gap between the cells. And they also have a, so cartilage, that is another matrix, another connective tissue, cartilage, another connective tissue. And this also have solid matrix. And bone also has solid matrix. Bone is rich in water. Matrix is rich in phosphorus and calcium. And here the solid matrix of cartilage is composed of proteins and sugars. It is composed of proteins and sugars. So cells are widely spaced, and it is composed of solid matrix is composed of proteins and sugars. And we know at the joints, one bone is joined to another bone, and at the tip of these bones are softened by cartilage. So no problem when we fold it, no problem. If it was hard, what happens? They may collide and problems may occur, but that is prevented by how the tips are softened by cartilage, tips of the bones. So they are soft tips, so no problem even if we fold that parts also. Okay, so if you touch cartilage, we can fold it. But when we take one bone, we can't fold that part. Why? This cartilage, the cells are widely spaced and the matrix is composed of proteins and sugars. But in bones, matrix is composed of calcium and phosphorus, and it is not flexible and strong also. Okay, the next connective tissue is areolar tissue. Areolar tissue. And this areolar tissue is found in our body in between the skin and muscles, and it is also present around our blood vessels and nerves, and also in our bone marrow. And it fills the spaces inside the organs. And also, so it fill the space in the inside the organs means it support our internal organs. And it also help in repair of our tissues. Okay. Then there is another tissue in our connective tissue in our body called adipose tissue. So another tissue is called adipose tissue. And where are the fats stored in our body? Usually if you are eating lot of fat, where these fats are stored? Usually below our skin and also in between our internal organs. We can see fats will be stored, and this adipose tissue are filled with fat. So which is the tissues that are filled with fat? Adipose tissues are filled with fat. So they are storing the fat below our skin and between the internal organs. And we know during winter season and all, when it is very cold outside, we will wear a sweater and all. So how the sweater keep our body warm? Sweater, there is air space between this sweater and this air space. Air is an insulator, so it won't allow heat from our body to go out. So it keeps our body warm. Like that, this layer of fat in our body also will act as an insulator. So when it is very cold outside and all, heat from our body won't go outside because this layer of fat is acting as an insulator. So it will keep our body warm. That is why fat people don't feel very cold when it is cold outside, because heat inside their body is kept inside their body itself, and they will feel warm also. Okay, so clear now? Okay students, now we can look have a fast look at the different types of connective tissues. Okay, so first is blood. So what about the matrix of blood? Blood have a fluid matrix which is rich in proteins, salts and hormones. And what is the function of blood? It carries respiratory gases, food, waste materials, hormones, etc. to different parts of our body. And next is bone. Bone have a solid matrix and it is composed of calcium and phosphorus. Then bone gives shape to our body, structure to our body, support to our body. Then one bone is connected to another bone by ligament and it has little matrix and it is elastic in nature. Then one bone is connected to muscles by tendon, and tendon has a fibrous tissue and it has limited flexibility. Then cartilage is the soft bone and cells are widely spaced in cartilage, and it also have a solid matrix and it is rich in proteins and sugars. Then what about areolar tissue? It is a tissue that fills the space between the internal organs, so it gives support to the internal organs. Then adipose tissue are the tissues that stores fat and it acts as an insulator in our body. Clear now? So study the different connective tissue and study about their matrix and function also. Okay, bye.